them. Don't worry.
Thank you.
George, don't let him leave yet!
Let's come out the exit door of a school. That's what you get to look at when you come out.
He's been doing a tour, walking across Canada. He's on the western leg of this tour right now. And I don't want to say too much before we get Kristopher in here. But Kristopher, as I said, has been walking across the country. And today we had some of our students, a few of our students, meet Kristopher down at City Hall and do a walk from City Hall up to the school as part of his walk across the country. And Kristopher is here to share a message with you today. And at this time, if we can just have Kristopher and the students come on in and do a little tour of the gym, can you please give Kristopher Knowles an LDR welcome? over here, Kristopher. As I said, Kristopher's 14 years old from Sarnia, Ontario. Long ways from home. And he's been on this western leg of his tour. He actually started back on January 8th. And he's been walking across on the western tour. He's going to be finishing the western tour June 17th in Vancouver. This is 146th stop on a 200-city tour across the country for Kristopher. After he gets to Vancouver, he will then be flying back to St. John's, Newfoundland, and starting the eastern tour, going from St. John's, Newfoundland to Toronto, and finishing his tour in Toronto in December 17th. So he's giving up a lot of his time to go on this tour, and he's got an important message for you. A little bit about Kristopher. What grade name, Kristopher? Grade 8. So he wouldn't be here for a couple of years if he was in Nelson, since we started grade 10. We might let you come up here a year early, though. Kristopher, a regular grade 8 kid, except Kristopher needs a liver transplant. Okay, and Kristopher is walking across the country for a reason. He's out to try to make a difference. He recognizes his situation, but he's also out to try to help everyone who may need a liver transplant or any kind of organ transplant now or in the future. And I think it's an admirable thing that Kristopher is doing, traveling across the country, getting the message out just how important this is. Okay, so at this point in time, I'd like to turn it over to Kristopher to tell you his story and what this is all about. Welcome, Kristopher.
First, I'd like to thank my road team. At the very back in the corner, my dad slash driver, Kelly Knowles. Doors, road manager George Marcello. And the guy beside him, film director who is making a movie on my walk, Merle Roberts. Hi, my name is Kristopher Knowles. I'm 14 years old. I've been waiting for a liver my whole life. The disease that caused me needing a liver is called biliary atresia. It is a common disease among infants. Sadly, most infants die shortly after birth. So far, I've been fortunate enough to still be alive. I've been in and out of the hospital most of my life. I've had over 20 operations that saved my life. I'm doing this walk to bring awareness to the shortage of organ and tissue needed. That's why I thought to myself that there is a way to save people's lives. And if I save a life or lives, it makes us all worthwhile. That's why I'm walking across Canada, to save the 4,000 men, women, and children that are in need of an organ. I'm trying to inspire everybody to be an organ donor. Tell your friends and family about your wishes, and if you do, you'll be my hero, as well as everybody else's. Please don't take your organs to heaven. Heaven knows we need them here. Alone, I can't do this, but together we can. Please make my wish come true. Thank you.
Thanks, Kristopher. And at this time, I'd like to call forward George Marcello from the Step by Step group, which is a nonprofit charitable organization that is working with Kristopher on this project. So George, would you like to come forward?
Rogers, how's everybody doing this afternoon? Oh, come on, that was pretty lame. The last goal was louder than that. How's everybody doing? How does that sound, Chris? Right? Okay, at this part of the assembly, what we do is something called Up Close and Personal with Chris. And it'll give a chance for the students here to ask some questions. To Chris or anything concerning organ donations and the campaign. But before we go there, I wanted to thank some of the following community supporters from your community. I want to thank the Best Western for helping out with accommodations. I want to thank the following restaurants: New China, Mazel And Main Street Diner for feeding us while we were here. Also want to thank the police department for giving an excellent escort this afternoon. The city of Nelson for receiving Chris at City Hall today. And I also want to take this opportunity to acknowledge the walkers that walked with Chris this afternoon. Please stand up. Thanks. And especially I want to thank Mr. DiBiase for helping to organize this great event today. Thank you. And of course, all the students that I gathered here today, you are the most important people. You are the reason why Christopher is doing this walk. And he is hoping to inspire everybody here this afternoon to think about organ donations. Now, usually there's that first brave hand that goes up right away as soon as we say, who's that first person that's going to ask that first question? I think I've seen a hand up there already. Mr. DiBiase, can you please recognize the people that are... Can you stand up?
Do you actually walk everywhere?
No, they won't let me walk the whole thing. I tried, but because of my health problem, I drive into the city and then I walk about 1 to 10 kilometers into the city. But because I'm going to about 200 cities, I'm doing more walking. Walking more than I walk. Yes. Actually, walking the whole thing.
He's suffering with a disease called Biliary Atresia. Probably not pronouncing it right.
Biliary Atresia.
that when he was 6 months old. Usually infants, unless they get their transplant, they die at the age of two. And Kristopher has survived 20 operations so far. He's probably got the record in operations for his age. Miraculously, he's alive because he's got an incredible will inside, an incredible spirit to survive. And what the disease does to him is it prevents him from playing physical sports. Looking at him, he doesn't look sick. I didn't think he was sick when I first met him. You know, he doesn't show any signs. He's got more energy than the whole team put together. And I don't know where he gets his energy from. I think he gets it from SpongeBob, because he's constantly watching that program. There's probably some kind of special powers. I don't know. But anyways, this kid's amazing, and nothing slows him down. If he's ever in pain, that means we've got to rush him to the hospital. And remember, he's operating with a quarter of his liver. You know, some of us with full functioning livers don't have half the energy he has. He's a cool kid.
Bands mostly.
Well, why don't you show them? Show
me your belly.
He's going to show you,
Chris.
His scars.
Show me.
That's the best way. And like I said, when you look at Kristopher, he doesn't seem like he's gone through all this. You know, that's the only way sometimes you can really prove it, that he's gone through what he's gone through.
It is London, Ontario. Yeah.
So that's where you're originally from, right?
No, I'm actually from Sarnia. Yeah.
How much medication do you take, and how much does it cost in a year for your medication?
Right now I'm just taking vitamins. And the only thing that pretty much we have to pay for is, it's called vitamin K. It's like in a little bottle. It's $5 a little box, so it's about $50 for a month.
And does the Ontario plan cover any of this, or is it all the family that has to?
Nope, just the family.
No, there's no real treatment or cure. There's no cure for it. And he's had to go through like 20 operations just to prevent from dying. You know, that's how gloomy it is.
It was every three weeks.
Once every 3 weeks.
Can you repeat the question, please? We can't hear what you're...
You had to have surgery once every 3 weeks.
The question was, how often does Christopher have to go for surgery? Up until he came on the walk, I think it was a couple of months just before he started the walk that we went to hospital. About a week before. And it was periodically, almost every 3 weeks or every couple of, about a week before, and it was periodically, almost every 3 weeks or every couple of months that he was going to the hospital. He's been on the road now for almost 5 months. Knock on wood, he has not gotten sick, and we've never had to rush him to the hospital.
Explain the bands, George, explain the bands.
It's a disease that's common shortly after birth, but there has been cases where, that's where most of the cases are, but there have been cases, you know, later on in life that you can contact the disease.
Are you managing to go to school once you're in?
For my walk, they're starting this, they wouldn't let me. They wouldn't have let me go if I had bad grades. So they let me on this walk because I have good grades. And so the only thing I have to do is write a journal every day and do a lot of email. That's what it
is. It's not hereditary. And if it's a mystery too, like if it's to get it another way from someone.
Is there anything other than becoming an organ donor and spreading awareness that we can do to support your cause? And what do you want to be when you grow up?
Well, George can ask you the first question, but the second question is two things. I want to be a surgeon, but you know, I'm not that smart to be that. And the second one is a famous soccer player.
And to answer the question, we do need help on the road. We're actually surviving on students' lunch money. We don't have any big grants, we don't have any big corporations on board. And we've gotten this far because, you know, Christopher's visited over 200 schools so far. Students have been pushing through. So that's how you can help. We have a toll-free number on the posters here. And I think shortly after the events finish, Christopher kind of planned himself out there and signed some posters and stuff.
Website.
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 I guess you can find some of it on our website. It's www.kristopherswish.ca, and tell the posters again, and George can tell you the other information.
Actually, the spelling of the word is a little difficult, Biliary Atresia, but if you go to Google, and just, on our website, there's a ton of information these days where you can get that kind of, more information about your disease.
Over there.
How many people receive organs?
Okay, there's presently about 4,000 people on the waiting list. And the question was, how many people from those 4,000 are going to receive organs? Usually it's about 30%. Almost every other day somebody has passed away on that waiting list. So we have a really urgent problem that we can fix here. That's why we're hoping the students right across Canada are going to lead the way.
Up at the top.
I know there's a ton of questions, which is great to see. So obviously, Kristopher, you've really made an impact on our student body. Unfortunately, some of them are going to have to catch a bus in a few minutes. So before we get to the end of the day, I'd like to call on Nandy Bronstein to come up and make a little presentation. Oh, she's got a friend coming with her, too. questions, and there was more to